I'll start here. So refining, this is kind of a 10,000 foot view of refinery. I'm not gonna go into specifics. You probably don't want me to go there, and I probably am not able to go there. So, anyway, I'll start here. So refineries are all, different, every single one of them. So what I'm talking about here is just a general refinery, kind of a typical one. Crude oil is different, and the products people make are different, so anyway, the internals are different. And speaking of which, we'll first talk about inputs and outputs, okay? Because, you know, the first thing they teach in those of us that didn't stick through the chemical engineering program, this is what you do to a complex system. You put it in a box and forget about it. So if you have this big system, all you do, there's a box, say, what are my inputs, what are my outputs, and then just forget about the rest. That's what you do. So we'll just talk about what goes into a refinery, what goes out of a refinery. We'll start there. So inputs is obviously what? Excellent. You guys are a sharp bunch. Crude. All right. Okay.
Yeah.
And the products, outputs.
Hey Dan, why don't you just run this so I don't have the whole thing in the back of your head?
Okay.
We got several outputs. So we got you got things like fuel gas. You have, you know, gasoline, whatever type you use, you know, premium or regular or some mixture of the two. And diesel. Some of you really enjoy diesel, I know. Jet fuel. And some other stuff, like LPG. That's liquid propane. That's what that is. Okay, now it's time for the part you've been waiting for, the organic chemistry primer.
Yes.
You ready? Okay, this is going to be tough. You need to memorize. Here we go. This statement. Structure determines properties. Okay, let's all say that. Structure determines. Oh, you got it.
Okay. Repeat after me.
Repeat after me. Structure determines properties. Okay, well, I'm glad you guys got crude oil.
Determines. I am. There we go.
Okay, so what does that mean? I'm not going to talk anything about boiling points and vapor pressures or anything like that. I'm just going to talk about what stuff looks like on the small level. If you know what it looks like on the small level, that's what determines everything else. So, crude oil, it's a big mixture of a whole bunch of stuff. It's got little dots, it's got little lines, you know, some squigglies, it's got some rings, you got some like X's and some double X's. These are all carbon chains. So it's just a whole big mixture of stuff, and there's like big sheets of rings, there's crazy stuff in there. And so what about fuel gas? Well, it's little dots. Alright, that's the structure. Gasoline is actually, on the microscopic level, is just a bunch of X's and O's. All right, it's crosses, circles with things coming off, double crosses, things like that. That's what gasoline looks like at the smallest level. Diesel is like, it's like spaghetti. It's just strings. You have all these strings. So it's a lot different than gasoline. And so that's why the engines that burn it are very different. Jet fuel is kind of a mixture of both of these. LPG is just short little pieces of carbon. So anyway, that's what I'm going to talk about. I'm going to be drawing little pictures and stuff, and not really talking about boiling points or anything like that, because that's not really, you won't remember that. Okay, the other thing you need to know is the word definition of this word. Catalyst. So Dan, what's a catalyst?
Speeds up a reaction.
All right, and does it get used up?
Not ideally.
Yeah. Okay, that's right. The catalyst makes the reaction go faster and doesn't get used up. It'd be like your car is a catalyst. If you put gasoline in it, transportation comes out of it, but the car is not used up. But like a car, eventually you have to replace it because it gets worn out. So anyway, that's what a catalyst is. So
the best catalyst in that case is a Ford.
Of course.
Yeah.
Of course. Because
it never moves.
All right. Also, when you hear people talk about crude, you always hear these terms like sweet and sour and light and heavy. And do you guys know what that means?
Yes.
Kind of? Mm-hmm. Yes? Okay, light crude means it tends to have more of this stuff. And heavy crude means it tends to have more of this stuff. It has
including the LPG.
Sorry, that goes on. That goes up here at the top. I'll put LPG right here, and I'll put one more thing down here. Is Coke, C-O-K-E. Not the kind on the table. This is kind of like a spongy black stuff. Some kind of comes in these little pellets, like look like buckshot or larger. Anyway, it's junk. You can't get much money for it. But anyway. One of the outputs. Okay, sweet and sour. So sweet is, it's about sulfur, okay? The more sulfur is in something, the more sour it is, okay? So sulfur goes up, sour. Sulfur goes down, sweet. This stuff is the kind you want, a light, sweet crude. That's easiest to process. The sour, heavy crude is, you got to spend more money to get the same thing out of it. Okay, so anyway, that's that. Next to, so now we're going to start talking about an actual refiner. The first thing, I'm going to kind of group these in these all these different pieces of the group by what they do. So the first thing is the crude unit. That's what everything comes into. All right, this is my high-tech media here. All right? So the crude oil comes into the crude unit, and basically what the crude unit does, put crude here, is it just organizes stuff. That's really what it does. It uses temperature to organize stuff kind of along what shape it's in. So you got out the top, we're going to call this light ends. All right, that's like methane, propane, butane, stuff like that. At the middle, you've got things like something called naphtha. Naphtha, when you see naphtha, just think like raw gasoline or heavy gasoline. That's basically what naphtha is. And then actually you also have straight run gas. This is going to get really crowded, I can tell. Okay. And then out of the middle you got this thing, stuff called diesel, jet fuel, but they're kind of still in raw states. And then got a couple more things go at the bottom. We're going to call it gas oil, but it's basically, this stuff is way too heavy to put in your car or in any kind of engine. Unless it's like a big ship or something like that. And then out the bottom, this is called, we're just going to call it the bottoms. This stuff is nasty. Okay, so it organizes. All right, makes sense? Crude unit just organizes according to what the structure is. So you can see there's three sections. There's the stabilizer section, the atmospheric section, and the vacuum section.
And you're using heat.
Temperature.
Temperature.
Yeah. Yeah, that's basically what it uses to separate things. Mm-hmm. Okay, so now all this stuff is, you can't sell it all. Right?
Oh, thank you.
You can't sell this for any money. You can't really sell this for any money. So we're going to start talking about these things that are so heavy, how do you convert them into stuff that makes money, like gasoline and diesel and jet fuel? That's the stuff you want to sell. So the first thing is we're going to deal with this bottom stream right here. This is really, really heavy stuff. So usually, most refineries put this into what's called a coker. And the coker just uses a lot of heat. So I guess temperature again. It basically just burns it. It burns it and then it separates out the stuff that's usable. And the rest of the stuff goes out the bottom as coke. That spongy black stuff. So that's what a coker does. There's other things you can do at the bottom, but typical refinery is going to have a coker. Some don't. But those are the ones that only take the light sweet stuff. Okay, the next unit we're going to talk about also kind of falls into this category of taking these big heavy molecules and splitting them up. That's the next thing we're going to talk about, is how do you take the heavy molecules and split them up? Catalytic cracker. This thing right here, put it right there. The cat cracker is like the heart of every refiner. It's the center. It's what converts the most. It's the most important process in refineries. And what does it do? Well, it takes gas oil from the atmospheric unit and the vacuum unit. It takes gas oil from the, I'm gonna move this here, from the coker. And it converts it into gasoline, mainly. It can do diesel too, but mainly gasoline. Anyway, that's what a FCC, that's another name for it, fluidized bed catalytic cracker. But that's what it does.
And what's it used?
It uses catalyst.
Temperature and catalyst, or just catalyst?
It uses
temperature and catalyst.
Yeah, and it's a fluidized bed of catalyst. So like a catalyst flows from one reactor to another back in the regenerator. So it's kind of a cool process, but it's pretty complicated.
So when someone says a cat unit, is that, because I've heard FCC and then you always hear
cat cracker.
Those are all
universal kind of. So,
well, the other one is the cat poly unit.
Yeah, that's different.
So that's a cat cracker.